For a while now, we've been discussing data analysis, specifically one-dimensional data analysis. This week, we're going to move into two-dimensional cases and see how we can glean information from two-dimensional data sets using scatter plots and modeling. In 1929, Edwin Hubble discovered a relationship between the distance of galaxies and the speed at which they move away from our place in the universe, proving that the universe is expanding. His data is displayed in the scatter plot below. We don't have an actual question yet. We're going to answer some later. First, let's make sure we understand what we're looking at here. So this is a scatter plot with X and Y, meaning every point on the scatter plot is an element of our data set with an X value and a Y value. In this case, distance and speed. In general, the two variables plotted on a scatter plot may or may not be actually related at all. If there is a relationship, we can sometimes be asked to model that relationship with a function. These can be some of the hardest problems we see on the SAT with scatter plots and modeling, so we're going to start with an example of that now. In 1929, Edwin Hubble discovered a relationship between the distance of galaxies and the speed at which they've moved away from our place in the universe, proving that the universe is expanding. His data is displayed in the scatter plot below. What function best models the relationship between the speed of galaxies S and their distance from the Earth D? When solving problems like these, there are two steps we need to take. Step one is we need to determine if a relationship exists between the two variables, and if so, what form that model relating the two variables is going to take. Step two is to fill in the parameters of such a model if it exists. First, is there a relationship between our two variables? Well, the problem statement here actually tells us there is, but as a counterexample, what if we had a scatter plot like this? In this case, there's clearly no relationship between X and Y. So relating these two scatter plots, it should be really easy to see what the difference between related and unrelated variables looks like in a scatter plot. Common forms, and especially the forms you'll be asked to use on the SAT, are linear, quadratic, and exponential. Now we've covered a lot with linear functions, and if you're unfamiliar with the other two, quadratic and exponential, don't worry, we'll be looking at those in some later videos. So how do we choose between these three models? Well, we need to look at their different shapes as seen here and see which shape our scatter plot most closely resembles. Here, it's not too hard to see that our data looks most like a straight line, so we'll choose a linear form for our model. We're eventually going to need to fill in our model with parameters, but to start, we just want to draw a line of best fit on top of our data, as we see done here. The next step is our parameters. Our function model is S of D equals MD plus B, where we substituted X for D, our distance, and F for S, the speed. So our two parameters are M and B from F of X equals MX plus B. Now we're going to fill in those parameters based on the data. We're gonna do this a little quickly. If you're confused, you can look back to our previous video on how to do this, equations of lines. We start by seeing that our line goes through the origin, telling us that B is equal to zero. Next, we need to find the slope. We choose one point on our line, this one at 35, 1500, and we plug that into our slope equation and find that our slope is about 42.8. This gives us a final equation of S of D equals 42.8 D. Now, comparing with our answer choices, we don't have anything that matches exactly with what we found, but we've done a lot of approximating, so anything pretty close is good enough. So looking through our answer choices, we see that A is pretty close to what we found, and that's our final answer. Okay, we have one more problem type to look at, but don't worry, this one's much easier than the one we did previously, so let's take a quick look through it. In 1929, Edwin Hubble discovered a relationship between the distance of galaxies and the speed at which they moved away from our place in the universe, proving that the universe is expanding. His data is displayed in the scatter plot below with a best fit line drawn. How much faster is the galaxy 52 million light years away moving compared to what is predicted by the model shown? This type of question is surprisingly common in the SAT. Fortunately, it's really straightforward to solve. You just look at the value given, find the point on the scatter plot and the point on the best fit line, and find their difference. Simple as that. Here we're asked the difference in speed, which is plotted on the y-axis. So first, let's find the value given to us. We were asked for 52 million light years, which we see here, our point on the scatter plot, and then we find the equivalent point on the best fit line. And then all we need to do to find the answer is just find that distance on the y-axis, which is about 400. We're only approximating, that's fine. And that's our final answer, it's 400. Okay, and that's about all you can expect to see on the SAT for scatter plots and modeling. So not only have you finished preparing yourself for this type of question on the SAT, you've also learned some really useful skills that you can apply outside of the SAT. Hope you liked the video. If you want to hear more and see what else we're up to, hit like and subscribe and see a new video coming out from Point Avenue every week. If you want to talk to us, hear more about what we're doing, or have any questions, email us contact@pointavenue.com. Bye!